as I just mentioned.
Scrutiny of the facts does not substantiate the claims of those who say that animal research is a necessary evil. In reality, there is no choice to be made between babies or dogs, as the advocates of vivisection would have us believe, but simply a choice between genuine science and false science. One certainly does not need to be an expert to realize that vivisection is, as described by ex-vivisector and author of Vivisection or Science, Professor Pietro Croce, a methodological error which has led medicine astray and which ultimately can never be of benefit to people. The reasons for this are fundamental. The survival of vivisection is based upon three basic arguments. Firstly, that it is possible to recreate a naturally occurring human disease in an animal, what vivisectors call an animal model of a human disease. This is, however, impossible. Diseases, artificially induced in animals, have nothing in common with naturally occurring human diseases, which arrive in people spontaneously due to a variety of, sometimes, unknown factors. Although we do know that exposure to certain environmental factors and unhealthy lifestyles over a number of years are responsible for many of the diseases that afflict mankind. Vivisectors often talk about creating a similar disease, but in the world of true science, the word similar is meaningless. The second false claim of the advocates of vivisection is that it is possible to learn about the human body and how it works by looking at animals. For instance, vivisectors attempt to learn more about the human immune system, the inbuilt system that protects us from disease, by experimenting on animals. But the immune system of animals is different to that of humans. Dogs are able to drink from muddy puddles without harm, while cats are able to clean themselves by licking dirt from their bodies, and rats are able to thrive in the filth of the sewers. But not only is the human immune system different from animals, so is the human cardiovascular system. The structure of our skin and eyes, muscles and bones are also different. We are also different socially and have different dietary needs. All species are different genetically. The third false claim in support of vivisection is that it is possible to predict human reaction to drugs and other chemical substances by testing them in animals. However, animals can in no way predict the human response to drugs due to differences in the way each species will react to them, and the different rates at which drugs are eliminated from their bodies. In the UK, all drugs are first tested on animals before they're given to people. The consequence of this is that the newspapers are, on an almost daily basis, reporting the removal of one drug or another following adverse effects in people, having led to horrific side effects, injury, and death. In 2004, it was reported in the press that prescribed drugs were the cause of 10,000 deaths in the UK each year, and in 2006 that as many as 250,000 people in Britain are hospitalised annually because of prescribed drugs at a cost of some £466 million. Needless to say, all these drugs will have undergone extensive animal testing. It has also been reported in highly regarded publications such as the British Medical Journal, the Journal of the American Medical Association, and New Scientist, that prescribed animal safety-tested drugs are the third and fourth biggest cause of death in the United States and UK respectively. One of the most recent examples of animal-tested drugs that have gone on to cause damage to human health is Vioxx. Manufactured by drug company Merck & Co. and prescribed for the treatment of arthritis and other conditions, it was shown to be both beneficial and safe in animal tests, and yet went on to being suspected of causing as many as 140,000 strokes and heart attacks in human beings before being withdrawn. However, there have been many, many other drugs which have been found safe in animal tests and have subsequently killed and injured people. And some studies have shown that the figure of 10,000 deaths each year from prescribed drugs in the UK could in fact be much higher. One can only guess at the number of people who have needlessly died and will continue to die due to this reliance upon the false methodology of vivisection. In 2006, there was widespread news coverage of the six men who suffered multiple organ failure in the testing of a new drug, TGN-1412. This had been tested on rats and monkeys and found safe in doses 100 times greater than those eventually given to the human volunteers. Of course, the very fact that drugs must go on to clinical trials after the animal studies is proof in itself that animal testing is no guarantee of safety, and that ultimately human beings are the real guinea pig. In fact, the whole purpose of the safety testing of drugs and other chemicals on animals is to provide an alibi when they go on to kill and damage human beings. Then it can be said that all the required safety testing has been done, thus ensuring drug companies do not face criminal charges. Animal testing is done for legal reasons and not for safety reasons. And this is proven by the fact that substances shown to be hazardous to animals still find their way onto the market. The reason for this is simple. Animal tests are meaningless in regards to human health. Animals do react differently to humans and indeed to other animals, to drugs and other substances. Not only that, but there can be huge differences in the way members of the same species react to a substance depending upon age and sex. What might be safe for a mature adult might be dangerous for a child, whilst that which is safe for men might well be dangerous to women. How much, then, must the differences be in the reaction to drugs between members of different species? Says Professor Crochet, the Amanita mushroom, which is deadly to human beings, is a delicacy for rabbits. Lemons, when fed to cats, will kill them, as will the common aspirin. Prussic acid, the mere smell of which can kill a human, is a fine aperitif for toads and sheep. Strychnine has no effect at all on guinea pigs, chickens, or monkeys. Arsenic, a favorite among murderers, can be tolerated in considerable quantities by sheep. And whilst vitamin C is essential for humans, removed from the diet of dogs, cats, or rats, they will nevertheless remain healthy, as their organisms produce their own vitamin C. The list is endless. In the late 50s and early 60s, 10,000 babies were born with birth defects. Responsible for this catastrophe was the drug thalidomide, prescribed